It is exciting, mainly because the deadline is crazy and there's a huge amount of work to do, but we're really up for it and we're really excited about it.
Look at this inch and a half stuff. Hopefully it's as nice as the inch. Grain's nice, but you can't always tell what you're gonna get. The colour looks consistent.
It looks really, really nice, doesn't it?
Yeah, it's lovely actually. We love what we do, absolutely love it. The joy of what we do is every day we come in and it's different, you know. And I mean, this is a big job for us, a big kitchen made out of English walnut and sycamore. It's going to be stunning, but I mean, it's quite unusual in a sense because we're normally making two or three things a month, so we're turning stuff over quite fast. There's always a kind of joy and a surprise when you take the surf, when you run something over the planer for the first time and you see what you get. There's that kind of lovely feeling of them. I mean, I say it's lovely, sometimes it can be awful if it's not what you expect. You know, sometimes the colour can be awful.
Yeah, it's like, wow, that's amazing, or, oh no, what have we bought?
The colour of this is just right for the job we've got. And actually, it's rather beautiful. Much more beautiful than we initially thought. It's kind of matured over time while we've been air drying it. Cost is much higher by using solid timber, and the labour element is higher as well, so it's a more expensive procedure. Using a completely stable sheet of ply or MDF or something like that is much quicker. You start with a flat sheet, you chop it up to size and you're away. With us making the panels, we have to plane the timber, we then have to kind of chop it to length, join them all together, you know, make sure we sort them so they look nice as a panel. There's an awful lot more work in that, and it does increase the cost, because it's probably three times more work.
The English walnut is unique because it's so rare. It's not farmed, it's not grown commercially, so you're lucky to find a tree. If you needed this amount of walnut, English walnut, for a job tomorrow, you would never be able to get it. We sourced this, we found it, we bought it, and we air dried it for 2 years, and then we had a mate that dried it in a kiln for us. Those are all specialist things that only really a small company, a small business like this can do.
We offer an absolutely bespoke solution. We offer the kind of notion of being able to sit down with somebody and designing everything down to the last detail. And that doesn't include, you know, unit Z with door B, you know, that is, how can we make best use of this corner? Would a sweeping curve be better here than a square unit? You know, what's going to go in there? And in a sense, in some ways we design from the inside out as well. So as well as designing something beautiful on the outside, I'm also thinking about how the spaces are going to work.
It's a privilege to use it because it is so special, but it's really daunting to start cutting into it. When you have it as a tree and a log, nothing's gone wrong. And then you start cutting this timber that is A, 200 years old, B, unbelievably expensive. You can't find any more of it and you've sold it to someone and then you've cut it wrong. What are you going to do? There's no going back. You can't just go and get another bit. So we have to make sure we get it right and do it justice, basically. So the kitchen's gone really well. The walnut has has exceeded our expectations. We didn't think it would be as nice as it is, and it's really, really rich. Rich colours and grain, it looks great. So the piece that you're looking at is part of the island. It's a curved section. It's probably 60% finished, this actual unit, and the whole job as a whole is about 70% through now. The workshop's been manic. We've been doing, starting at 7, I've been working weekends because we started late, but that was mainly because of the walnuts. The highlights of the job really so far for me have been the doors. The curved doors have been absolute triumph. They look great. And the flat doors as well, the inset detail with the panel, it just looks fantastic. They were really good fun to make, so we can't wait to get out on site and start fitting it, which hopefully we will be in about a week's time.
Going very well. We've kind of pretty much finished the first stage of the fit. We're now in the position where plumbers and electricians need to do their little bit. So pretty much all the cabinet work is in, and it's gone very well. I mean, we allowed 3 days for this part of the fit, and it's taken 2.5. So actually,
so long as we get off site for 3.
So shorter view. Yeah, the one's gone. You always have this kind of part of the relationship with the client where they're just desperate to have their kitchen finished.
Here we have got that line. Can we throw a bit more light over this way?
The thing that tends to limit us, in a sense, is normally the appliances, which are square boxes that normally fit in 600mm gaps. And you know what you're really looking for is a happy client. That's the ultimate test, hopefully they should be over the moon with it.
Yeah.
I hope so, because it's quite a special kitchen. It's quite kind of low key and refined, which I like. It's kind of deceptively simple.
It's really unusual to see this much English walnut though in a room, isn't it?
Yeah.
And it's such a subtle blend of colours and tones.
I think when we speak to them next week, we'll get a clearer idea of how happy they really are. But I think they'll be pleased to have a quiet house tonight and just kind of look over it in the kind of the quietness of the evening. So.
I was kind of nervous about using so much walnut in one kitchen, but actually it looks fantastic. We're really, really happy with it. First glance, it looks like a relatively simple kitchen, but actually things like the fact it's a Freyman style door, but it's a Freyman style door which is on a very slight curve, even the panel's curved. And obviously the selection of the timber, there's a great deal of kind of delicacy and sensitivity in terms of the way we select the wood. So those kind of subtle things, and it's shadow lines, it's the kind of gaps between things that kind of match the gaps in the panels. It's those little fine details that it takes somebody with a real eye to kind of understand that. They've been fabulous clients because they understand that kind of richness of detail. I mean, they've got a collection of really interesting furniture here, both contemporary and old. And it's because a great piece of furniture transcends its time. It's great furniture. And that's what we try and make. We make great furniture, whether it's in the form of a piece of a kitchen or as a freestanding piece, you know.
The design lends itself to just using the walnut because it's so unfussy. There's not masses and masses of detail within the kitchen. It's just all about, you know, it's really pared back. It's just all about the walnut and the colours and the subtle contrast of the grain within the timber. As a showcase for walnut, it's a pretty good example. As a showcase for us, I think it's fantastic. Anyone who came into the kitchen knew anything about manufacturing and design ought to look at it and think, wow, you know, it's a really, really pared back example of good design and exquisite making. I'm just refinishing the sycamore top because they have a cat who has a tendency to walk across it and leave sort of paw marks all over it. So while we're on site anyway, just thought I'd give it a refinish. You work with the grain the whole time, up and down nice and slowly, so the thing is kind of basically completely covered in the Danish oil. Leave it for a few minutes and then rag it off with a dry rag, which is the last bit, which is what I'm doing now.
I quite like walking away from a job, to be honest. I think once it's the clients, it's the clients, you know. We don't feel over sentimental about it, because in a sense, being design led, it always means we're wanting to kind of push on to the next thing, the next project. It's a kind of constantly evolving process, you know. We're always moving on and changing.